Hi there, Simon from simonwoods.com. Five Douro reds in front of me, spanning vintages from 2011, missing out 2010, then a 9 and three 2008s. Dig in. The 2011 is a Tons de Duorum, and let's give it a whirl. I think this is the fourth vintage for Tons de Duorum. It's a project between a guy called, what's he called, Jose Maria Suarez Franco, who I think he was the first winemaker at Barcavea, and João Portugal Ramos. I remember the first vintage, I thought the red was okay, and I've watched it get slowly better. And I stick my nose in here, and this has got all the spice, the fruit, the perfume that I'm wanting from a less ambitious Douro red. It's under a tenner, but it feels like it's got something of the place. It's got some of that warm earthiness, and then this jolly, joyous fruit. Berries, it's got the plums, damsons, and an exuberance with it. Yeah, young, lively, earthy. Good glug, really, really good. Soft. It's one of those ones that you'd almost say soft but firm. And what I mean by that is there's a firmness of the tannins, there's a chewy backbone, and then it's got this plush, soft fruit round it. Not too plush that it's gone sweet and bimbo-like. Good drink, really good drink. Next one, down to 2009 here for, I could probably mispronounce this and get arrested, Lisieres, anyway, bottled by Agricola de Romanera, so we've got a wine from Quinta de Romanera coming up next. I don't know whether this is their entry level one, but anyway, I better try it and not try and pronounce the name again. Well, I'm not sure whether the Douro would have made a wine like this 10, 15 years ago. First of all, colour-wise, it's not pale and shy, but it's not especially deep in colour. And it's 13% alcohol, so on the lowish side for the Douro now. It used to be that they used to try and make the biggest, boldest, butchest wines possible. Now they're trying to make something that's a little bit more elegant and a little bit more fragrant, and some estates doing it more than others. Interesting that the Romanera that I've got next is similar alcohol. These two are 13, next to a 14%. But this seems to put more an accent on earthy fragrance. The fruit is there, and it is probably the starring role. But it's not one of those stars that elbows everyone else out of the way. It lets some of the soil characters come through, and the gentleness and the fragrance, and it feels like it's going to be tasty and refreshing. And yes, refreshing is the right word. This there's the soft, and the fruit is certainly ripe. There's no unripe edges there. Although some people might object to that slightly herbal, leafy edge that I don't know which of the grape varieties bringing that to the party. It's not jammy. It's not overripe. It's there's a freshness and vitality about it, and I'm not sure whether it's been anywhere near barrels. I'm not sure whether it says anything on the back about that, but it feels unadulterated. It feels like someone's just been very happy to make the wine in a reasonably, I hesitate to use the word natural way, but. But hasn't fannied around with it, for want of a better term, and in the process has made a really nice, lovely, gluggable wine. Let's see whether we can say the same for it's not his big brother. I think there's a bigger brother called Quinta de Romanera, and there might even be a Quinta de Romanera Reserva. But this is Sino de Romanera. I could be getting all my Romanera hierarchy completely skew-whiff, but I will report back if I've got it in the wrong order. But I think that there's maybe a wine above here, or maybe a wine below here. I'll shut up and taste it. Sino apparently refers to a bell, and there is a bell like this on the label that hangs somewhere over the entrance of the main house of the Quinta. I don't know if you remember Leslie Phillips going Miss Bell Ding Dong. It is a bit of a ding dong of a wine. It takes the gentleness and hearty, earthy fruit of the previous one, adds a little bit more plushness, but does it without, increasing in alcohol. What it does seem to have is more layers of flavour. And I think that, yes, there'll probably be a little bit of oak involved here that's added some mellowness, but has not taken away from the fruit. I think you're going to get more concentration of fruit flavours here, but still with that element of freshness. Well, this is another live, lovely and interesting wine, and confident in its gentleness. It feels like whoever has made this... I'm trying to remember, I can't remember whether 2007 was the first era, modern era of Quinta de Roman era, or was it? No, it was 2004 or so. Oh, I don't know. I'll see if I can dig it out and plonk something on the screen for you. But what I remember about the first wave of wines, they were a bit more bold and maybe more Bordeaux inspired. I don't know. No, I hesitate to use the word Bordeaux inspired, but here it feels like someone's got a Burgundian touch about it, and they're interested in gentleness, elegance, and fragrance. And you've got a rounded, lovely, complete wine. And the one before was good, but here it's a step up in class, not a step up in density, but just step up in extra layers of flavour. Really tasty. Let's try the second 2008, which is Quinta de Tedo. Now, recently, wine I've had from these guys most recently was their pink port, which was the best pink port I've had. Admittedly, the field in which the field of pink port is not exactly large, but let's see how they are for their table wine. And this is much more traditional Douro, if you can talk traditional about an area that's only really been making table wines probably for not much more than two decades. It's bold, it's rich, it's ripe. There's a raisiny, overripe plum character, bit of Brettanomyces in there, adding some savoury characters. It smells okay. I think the previous one was a hard act to follow, and they really are chalk and cheese in terms of in terms of style. But anyway, I don't want to diss it too much without tasting it. And it's got that dark damson skin fruit and that skinny character. That for me is one of the Bretty signs. And the finish I'm left with is just that little bit too dry, desiccated. It feels like the fruit here got really, really ripe. At 14% alcohol, there are higher alcohol Douro wines, certainly. But there's some dried grape character there, and that just little bit of desiccation that is taking away from the fragrance and charm. It's okay. But I think that the previous one is the future. Let's see whether we are in the past or the future with the final one, which is Quinta do Infantado 2008 Reserva. Give it a whirl. Now, this smells like a slightly less raisiny version of the previous one. It has got that bold, dark fruit, the berries, the black currants and the damsons, but without that slight desiccation and brett that was in the previous one. Now, that takes the good elements of that, as in the bold fruit, the berries, the black currants, the damsons, adds a little bit more freshness and also a little bit more of that wildness, the herbs, the sense of the soil. And it is a big bold wine. It sort of like says to a steak, come on. But I think that they'd have a bit of a tussle and then they'd go away with their arms around each other and probably have a good night out on the town. I think I prefer the Roman era, but I can fully understand why people would prefer that. And for me, they're as good as each other. And I think it's good that a region is capable of doing the lighter style and the bolder, more butch style. I prefer this, but as I say, some people will prefer the other. But I think in terms of a set of five wines, they were all... Tedo was... okay, but the other four were all made me think. Okay, sometimes I'm thinking, oh, I actually like the wines of Douro, Byrne, and the Douro is can be a little bit samey. But you taste a row of wines like this, and you just think, actually, they're doing a pretty good job. Hopefully I've done a pretty good job. Hopefully you'll go out and buy lots of these wines. And, I mean, a tons de Douorum, what is it, £8? £8.20? Bargain. Fill your boots. And fill your boots with some of the others too. See you soon.